Did you hear about that woman from Brazil? Had a 16-pound baby. Good Lord, where'd they make love? Next to a microwave? Yeah. He had to hand out special cigars that said, "It's a man." That kid drove himself home from the hospital. Then there's a 62-year-old had her 19th baby. The reporter, "How long are you in labor?" "How long was..." What a dumb question. Thing just rolled out like a ripe coconut, for God's sake. The hardest part was keeping it in for 9 months. She had to stand on her head the last 3 weeks, keep it from rolling out in the game room, for Pete's sake. My little girl's breastfeeding right now. My little boy's weaned off of it, and I still take a swig every now and then when I get a chance out there. My wife wants to get her boobs redid. You believe that? 15 grand. And that's not counting mounting and balancing. All right, that's just a straight up stick 'em up her. But I worry about her, though. I love her. I want something to happen. They put chemical in your body, for God's sake. What is it? They put the saline and what's a silicone, wood chips? Who the hell knows what they're putting in there? They better not put wood chips in titties. That pissed me off. Fire ants take a liking to wood chips. I don't want to go down there and get a nipple lick, get bit by a queen ant. That'd be ridiculous right there. I'll tell you what I want. I want to fill her titties up with Dorothy Lynch salad dressing. That's what I want her to do right there. That's what I want. Boy, that'd be delicious. That's right. What do you want on your salad? I got it. Right there. I got two whole jugs of it right here with me. Love that Dorothy Lynch. Actually, you know what would be cool? Fill them things up with helium. That'd be nice. Then when we're making love, I can squeeze them together and make funny little cartoon voices all night long. Hey, honey, how was that?
Boy, that felt really good. Oh, that was delicious.
We played a trick on my mom one time. My wife has a breast pump. She gets milk, puts it in the freezer and stuff. And actually, that kind of stinks, so I rigged it so she can put the shop vac up there. You know, that's real nice. The bad thing is, you take them off her nipples like that long. When you're done with that whole thing, it's tragic. But the kids like it. They'll jump rope, whatever. You know, they enjoy it. It's kind of a little game right there, you know, a Swiss Army game or something. But I took one of them bottles of milk and I replaced it. I put one of her bottles of milk and I replaced it with a real bottle of milk. And my mom come down. She said, "Boy, she worked hard today. She got 5 bottles right there." I said, "I'm going to drink one of them." She said, "Don't drink that. That's baby milk." I said, "I'm just going to drink a little bit." She goes, "Don't do it. I will pass out. Do not do it." Down she went right there. It's not that funny. It killed her. I feel bad about it. I probably shouldn't have done that. She never woke up from the coma, and I feel bad about even telling the story. I actually used to love milk, and I still do love milk, but I had to lose some weight, so I kind of quit drinking the milk, and I went on diet. I lost 50 pounds last year, and yeah, 50 pounds. That's right. Look at me. I'm a rope. No, my wife told me if I lost 10 more pounds, she'd let me back on top. So I'm pretty excited about that whole deal. 50 pounds. That's a lot of weight right there, 50 pounds. That's an Olsen twin. My wife told me if I wanted to lose weight, I ought to try yoga. You ever try yoga? The hell with that. I tried yoga once. I never want to get my nose that close to my butt crack again, all right? And I had a chili dog before I went in there. If I knowed I was going to be folded up like a sandwich, I'd have never went in there. Going there for a 20-minute yoga session, I come out looking like a coal miner.